If you want to see this amazing telescope, was 20 years abandoned, so please check this out, man. This is going to be amazing. Plus, something very special I found, so check this out. You're not going to miss this episode. Only on Live Polarex is coming to you. Welcome to Live Polarex. This is one of the greatest telescopes in the world. Check this out, the 5-inch Polarex is coming now on YouTube. Hey, I put the lens on here, so yeah, super cool. And now I'm gonna put the tube on. I want one hand. Let's do it. I found on this book very special, called the illuminated crosshair eyepiece. If I say it good, I have to find it, you guys. Sorry.
Yes,
I got it. So this I found this in this area. I will show you later.
It looks like the same I found on the internet.
Maybe you can see it. The crosshair. Wait. There's also a very cool feature.
So, you can do Fey Week if you want to. If this is the sharpest, I think, yeah. Oh, that's so cool, you guys. This was our talking about 10 times 60. Something amazing, you guys. Oh wow, this is so cool, huh? This telescope is crazy, guys. Now, let's see the difference. This is the 4-inch telescope. This is the 4-inch. Look at my finger. You can see my finger. This is the 4-inch telescope. Look at my finger. Look at my finger. You see the difference? See the difference? How big this is? Oh wow. Oh, this is crazy telescope, you guys. Let's do an image. It goes down there, you guys. Let's do like a little bit the same. Everything is balanced good, you know. It's so cool, you guys. Actually, I don't have to do nothing. It's already balanced, you guys. Let's do a little bit upstairs. Maybe you want to see them from far off. Or far away. You can see far away again. Let's see. This is fake, you guys. This is like an Back to the Future thing, you know? Cool, cannot wait to activate this. This is so cool, this guy belongs to this guy from Norway, Karsten, his name is Karsten. So I will make a little short film of him. Hey, this is, believe it or not, this telescope I have on this from Norway, you know. I drive 4 days non-stop with my friend, so and plus 2 days sleeping in a car, so yeah, it has to be a little bit crazy to get a telescope, I would say. So so now this from 1947, see, Norway Amateur Observatory. Wow, it's super cool. Now let's look. Yeah. This is a rare preview. I'll show you. Let me come in there. See the Unitron? See, this is the 6-inch, that's the 4-inch. I have this one. We don't have this drive motor, you can say. So this is 6-inch, mine is a little bit tinier. It's the a little tinier. But hey, I don't care. Nice telescopes. And I have to say, in the old days, the telescopes were also not cheap, I have to say. Ah, here is you guys. This is my telescope home. Yeah, it'd be fun actually to make one, huh? Just for the fun. To make a copy of this home. Kijk hier dit. On the high ground in the southern Norway custom Dibritz wrote the foundation of his observatory as soon as 1971 fiction downhill. Wow. Super cool. I'm so excited, you guys, I cannot read anymore. So sorry, you have to read by yourself, okay? So I'm going down now. So you have to maybe do pause. See, there's the pier on here. Ah, super cool, you guys. Wow. Is this amazing or what? Wow, and this one. This is more amazing. He show his home, how to make it. This is more amazing. Wow. Super cool, you guys. And check this out, also from Kasteren, in the snow, wow. That guy is really a tough guy, you know. I have more fun photos to show you, so keep looking. The chair of him. It is Kasteren himself. Wow, quite cool, man. Try to do zoom in good, but yeah, hey, what do you want? I do everything by hand there. So yeah, that was the, yeah, I think that was everything, I believe. Oh, there's another one here. Oh, I did not see that one. See, this one is shot. See it? Check. On here, see it? That's the home. See it? Oh wow, closed, open. It looks like this was all fallen down on my pictures. This, wow, see that? You see how much it fallen down everything? Ah, wow, wow, super cool, you guys! Unbelievable! I have this telescope. This telescope was sitting somewhere inside a forest. So. Yeah, you can get it if you found it. But it's very hard to find this, I can tell you. This is the end now. I can look more, but I don't think it's a lot of funny telescopes. But I think it's all the ends, I believe this. And this is the effort I found, yeah. Actually, I was first looking on internet. I saw this first on internet, this one. And then I saw this, I said, hey, wow, that looks like my thing. Now if I look here, if I look closely, look like they put other screws on it or something, I have no idea, but yeah, if you I try to do a close-up. Yeah, you can see, huh? But this is my finger, so it's very, see my finger, it's very close-up I do, you know? You can see, so okay, now that was the book, see, the observatorium book, but this is the, you can see the four inch telescope, and this is the 5 inch telescope, you can see, a little bit bigger, cool, also special glasses is, you can see, finger, you can see. See, look at my finger, how big it is. And check this out, how big this is. This is crazy. This telescope is beautiful, you know. Okay, I can show you more little fun details. I can see, let's say about this knobs. You can see the little knobs here. Screws on it. So this one is a little bit newer, I believe. But this was 20 years, this telescope was 20 years in some kind of little forest. Oh, I cannot believe this, you know. I have all documentation, all documentation I have. So it is actually a museum quality, you can say. So see, let a little bit tidy it, polish it a little bit. So I see it not polished this, I see. But yeah, I have to clean it still a little bit more, so like this little screws or something like that. But how more you look at it, kijk, the proof is in the pudding. I can show you. This the Polarex, you see, the Polarex NS-132F. And we go here, see, it says the Unitron on here, NS-136. So it's also a little bit for, and this I'm gonna make open, yeah, for a special, and I want to know what's in here. I believe there's nothing in here. See that? It's just the same motor as this, but why is this on it, I wonder? You know? There's also a fun thing in here. See, there's sun protection. A little eyepiece in here. Wow. How more you look at it, how cool it becomes. Wow. This telescope is unbelievable. Look at the weights. Look at my finger. Finger. this little piece here. That's also a big piece. Look at my finger. Finger. Oh, wow, that's crazy. Look at the side. Look at the finger. Look how big this is, man. This is unbelievable, this telescope. This telescope is really unbelievable. I have to do something about that, so yeah, it will come all way in the future, I hope. I hope to get a museum, some kind of small museum, working museum, not standing museum. Of course you have to really let this work, you know. Beautiful, everything goes super smooth, you know. Oh, yummies. You have no idea how happy I am, you know. How happy I am. This is the guide scope, 75mm by 1200mm. So, wow, is that cool or what? And this is the moon. So the moon. So I have to put a little cover. Actually, my cover is. Yeah, put this on for now, for against the dust. So I put them in like so. It says boerin yoghurt. It means farmer's yogurt. It says if you want to know what's in Holland's. Yeah. Wow, this is so amazing telescope device. But actually, it's the same, huh? Everything is the same. The pier. I'm also surprised about the pier, you know. Because the pier nearly the same. Kijk, de pier. Let's see. This is. I checked this all. So the pier is all the same. Let's say 74 centimeters. And if we go to here. Here also a little bit. It's all the same. 100% same. And this, there's a little bit, there's 15 centimeters it says. 15 centimeters, and this is a little bit smaller. This is a little bit smaller. It's 12. And kijk, this is also a little bit different. Oh yeah, if you turn this, kijk, see? This stays on here. Those water level, we call it, yeah. But on this one, is stuck, the water level. See? I'm turning by one hand, actually. Super smooth, you guys. This was nearly forgotten, you guys. The one special guy, he found this telescope with somebody else. I don't know his name, but I put the link down, so they found it there first. Otherwise, maybe this telescope was forgotten forever, this telescope. Oh, wow. Everything is like new, you know. This is not original, so I have maybe some black screws, so this all will change to black screws.
Open wide and say ah.
So they have to drill it out, those guys. They cannot take it out. Oh, wow. But This is, oh yeah, I can, oh, it's still burning me. Oh, no, it's not. Actually, I had to make this open, have to drill it through, because it was all rusty. So it was actually very scary to do, but I had no choice, because it was not working, and now it's working fine, so. I only drill and put a new screw in so to make contact with the battery, so yeah, I'm super happy it works again, you know. But it's still eating battery. If it's all or off, it's still eating battery, so I have to look again, so. Hey, and also I forgot about this feature. This is the, the sim protection rod. They close this hole, but on the 4-inch, see it? Also the sun lens record. So I'm also going to do that. So I'm going to make this closed. So see it? There's another one. This one is thicker than steel. See that? Wow, it's funny, you guys. Yeah, this. Looks like two the same. This little thinner, yeah, I see. This 60mm and this. Yeah, okay. So, also a little fun detail to see. Okay. Let's go. Oh. Oh, yeah, I have to show you this. Can you see? This telescope is so special. And big, huh? Wow. I cannot stop looking at this, you know. And maybe you also think that, wow. 4-inch. I actually forgot to put this in, so but I still have it. This is 100% complete, this one. So but I'm more focusing on this one. So Polarex, see the Polarex in the Unison, so it's confirmed it work. They work together, so this is very beautiful, but this is more beautiful, you guys. Look at this, is, wow. You want to hear the motor, actually, yeah, let's start the motor, actually, yeah. Let's start the motor. See, okay, I've got the keyboard here. You hear it, you guys? Wow. And this will turn a little bit tighter, and this will go around the screw, I see. Yeah, it's going up now, the screw. So it's also fun to see, the close-ups. Thank you for watching, and I don't know what's going to happen. So I'm saying bye bye and pressing off.
Baby, please don't go. Karsten, det Britt. Baby, please don't go down in New Orleans. No love, so baby, please don't go. Yeah.